Hi everybody, welcome again to the YouTube channels of Zoran. I'm Dino Esposito and we are here in the beautiful city of Banja Luka after a wonderful conference experience they've hosted. Zoran, are you here?
Yes.
Oh, you wanted to interview me, right?
Yes, and thank you for lifting the burden.
You were so shy, so please have your questions.
Thank you for being such a wonderful host today. Welcome everybody. Here we meet at the conference in the wonderful city of Banja Luka, and I was already planning to make a video about the KISS principle on my channel, and then I thought, well, we have Dino Esposito here, and who can say it better than Dino? So, Dino, please tell us what comes to mind when you hear about the KISS principle.
A movie? Yeah, Billy Wilder movie, Kiss Me Stupid. With the story of a singer that get fall in love with a beautiful girl. So I don't remember the actress, but no, it's wonderful comedy. I think over the 60s or the 50s, whatever. So that's it. So you mean Kiss, Keep It Simple? Keep it super simple. Should we be politically correct and call it Keep It Super Simple, or just against the stream and call it Keep It Simple? Comma stupid
always annoyed me somewhat, but I must admit I didn't know about the movie. Now I have a different perspective on it.
No, Keep It Simple is also the famous quote from Einstein. Keep it simple as possible, but no simpler. I wrote that on I don't know how many hundreds of books. Every time that someone asks me to sign a book, I just write in various forms the Keep It Simple quote extract from the Einstein thoughts. And Keep It Simple is and should be the fundamental one of the fundamental principles of software development, because if it's not simple, I would even say it's not software that works. Maybe it works, but it's not software that works in the long run. Too often we focus on the fact that software has to work. As long as it works, there is no difference between good code that works and bad code that works. If you take this at a time T, but if you move ahead the timeline and move towards time T plus something, plus a delta, it's a different story. It starts being a different story because it works now, but in the long run, it may not work in the same way, not because a software alters itself running, is subject to obsolescence, but because in the long run, software needs to receive treatment, to evolve, to change, and maintaining and growing software, usually a software evolves because complexity is added on top of it. So keeping it simple as possible, but at some point you have to write instructions, concrete instructions, is the only way. And failing on that is, is a crime.
You said an interesting word, complexity.
Yep.
Complexity, complex versus complicated.
That's exactly, complexity is part of the world. Complicated is probably when you don't handle complexity in the proper way. Software is overall a very simple kind of science or application of science. In software, like probably in physics, there are a few universal principles that are the same and will be the same forever. One of the fundamental principles in software is separation of concerns, which was formulated in, I think, the 70s by Edgar Dijkstra, one of the pivotal experts and pioneers in software engineering. And it's all about keeping it interoperable but independent. And when you essentially have these blocks of code that can be connected together, is like in math, you can perform basic operations using plain numbers, or literals or full expressions or functions. It's still the basic operation of making a sum, a subtraction, a multiplication, whatever, one of the four fundamental operations, but the subjects of those operations may be as complex as you like without being complicated.
It comes to mind that the keeping it simple today in modern software is closely related to abstraction. What was the separation of concerns many decades ago is now implemented through abstractions, through dependency injection, through concepts like that in modern languages. What would you say?
I would say that essentially, yeah, the abstraction is the mechanism through which you put complexity while keeping the overall artifact as simple as possible. We don't have to confuse the fact that simple is basic. Simple is something that you understand at a glance, something whose logic unrolls in a way that is easy to follow, and that makes essentially sense and comes from start to an end. The software we write is inevitably and inexorably complex, more and more complex, with a lot of functions to be implemented. So we cannot simply say it has to be simple and short. It has to be as simple as possible. And the mechanism to keep things simple while implementing complex functionalities is abstraction. So recognizing, to make an example, that a function that at stage one, when things are really simple, is as simple as reading from a file, at some point can become a more abstract kind of function, like getting data from a source. But once you make this step up, so from the concrete implementation of reading bytes from a disk file to getting data from a data source, it's the same operation. So for outside this black box, it's the same operation, providing data from some source.
Yes. And when you say using basic means is not what makes it simple, did I understand you right?
Yep. Yeah?
I have noticed a tendency, which I think is not put well, in an attempt to make it simple, to make something simple that is not simple, complexity will always be there. But we want to move it out of sight and to focus on a task we are solving in one part of code, right? Some developers, I believe wrongly, try to solve the problem of complexity by stepping down to basic programming principles rather than doing more of the design, so to remove the complexity away from the part of code which shouldn't depend on so much complexity, should not contain it. So they, for example, step down to imperative coding, remove abstractions, remove dependencies, things like that. Have you noticed that?
Absolutely. It's there are two basic code smells that I find in the code. I work full-time for a company of which I'm the CTO, but also responsible for development of software applications. We are not a software company in the sense that we sell software licenses, but we use software for achieving and running our own business. So I check out and code of a number of developers, about 30 different developers. Yeah, it's commonly I see a couple of things. One is a code smell that it's commonly called data clump. So when you move around from place to place, from function to function, a number of different values as loose values, instead of putting them together into a class that is a DTO, that is something that represents business-wise a more reasonable entity. Another code smell is what you said exactly, the excessive use of imperative coding, in which which developers essentially put ifs on top of ifs, inside of ifs and whiles, to perform operations, losing completely the perspective of the real high-level tasks as if they are they look unable to watch the code from a drone or from a plane flying, you know, 10,000 feet from the ground. So from the high-level view, you see the topology of the code, and all I see is like a traffic jam, like a queue that develops on a street instead of looking something that looks more like blocks that are connected together, like, you know, I don't know, maybe like buildings or maybe castle fortresses. We have a beautiful fortress here in Banja Luka, fortresses of the past. So often when I am called to fix issues that developers are hitting and they run into a sort of roadblock, I go there, and after some effort, the code is cleaned. Usually the code that is effectively pushed to Git repositories is a quarter of the original size, uses totally different abstractions, so class names, class containers, and the interaction between those containers is surprisingly simple, obvious, crystal clear. This is keep it simple, even though the overall total absolute complexity of the functions implemented is the same as it was before.
I understand you totally. I have seen that many times. Can we conclude this somehow? For example, could we call programmers not to despair, not to say that the paradigms are guilty for complexity, but to look for better ways to use either object-oriented or functional, whatever they are choosing, not to abandon that, but to seek simplicity within the project they are making?
I would take this even further and arrive to say that as an advice from an individual with a lot of, with few hairs, but gray, few and gray hair. Essentially, it's also, in the end, it's a matter of education. It's a matter of where you studied and how much you studied. Software development is mostly about using abstraction in the right way. It's a powerful tool, probably the only tool we have well beyond any sort of technology. We can use it. We only need to master abstraction. And abstraction actually comes from logic, it comes from mathematics. So in the end, it ultimately boils down to what you study at university. What is your path of study? Personally, I figured out the power of abstraction, studying calculus, theorems, reducing formulas to something simpler, and thinking that you can do the same, just isolating blocks that look similar, giving them another name. This is abstraction, and it's taught via mathematics, logic, logical reasoning, and these things are for the most part taught at university. So the simple use of technology frameworks, libraries, doesn't work in the long run and is not the ideal tools to leverage the power of software and defeats the purpose of KISS. Keep it simple, comma, stupid.
I'm left speechless. And I was right. Dino is the guy who can explain this much better than I can. And I hope that you will watch this again, because this deserves watching twice.
Okay. And yes, if you watch it and you like it, email Zoran so we can have more sessions talking about other topics like dry, wet, Yagni and many others.
Dozens of others, why not? Thank you for being with me. Thank you for being such a wonderful guest or host.
Host.
And hope to see you again at the next conference. Why not?
Okay, bye.
Thank you, bye.